Hello, I trust we are doing well today. We'll be taking our Bible reading from Matthew chapter 13 from verse 24 to verse 28. We're going to take four verses from that particular chapter. Reason being that we need to get a good understanding of what this story is all about, then we'll be able to, by the grace of God, get a better interpretation to it. Can we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, we're about to enter and read in your word this moment. We pray that your Holy Spirit will give us utterance, will give us the wisdom, will give us understanding into your word. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. As usual, I'm using my King James Version, my favorite version of the Bible. And can I employ us, please, if you're at home, could you bring out your Bible so we'll read together? If you're out and about, you could use the Bible app on your phone as well and read, so that we all will get a grip of what the Holy Spirit is about to minister to us this moment. And can I say, this particular teaching and our previous teachings, if you have any comments, suggestion, insight into what have been taught so far, please don't hesitate to leave a comment on the YouTube page and tell us what you think about the messages. God bless you in Jesus' name. So back to our reading. Matthew chapter 13, verse 24 to verse 28, and I will read. It says, "Another parable put he forth unto them, saying, The kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field." Please, could you underline the word "good seed"? "But while his men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat." Please, could you underline the word "tares"? "And went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So the servants of the household came and said unto him, Sir, didst not thou sow good seed in thy field? From hence then had it theirs." Verse 28 and the last verse. "He said unto them, An enemy had done this." Could you underline the word "an enemy had done this"? I'll run through it again without stopping to say underline this or underline that particular line. So I'll take it again. Matthew chapter 13 from verse 24 to verse 28. "Another parable put he forth unto them, saying, The kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat, and went his way. But when the blade was sprung up and brought forth fruit, then appeared the tares also. So the servants of the householder came and said unto him, Sir, didst not thou sow good seed in thy field? From hence then had it tares. He said unto them, An enemy had done this." Praise the Lord. This particular place we read, the Bible is telling us this is a parable that Jesus Christ gave to his disciples about the kingdom of God. But by the special grace of God, we'll be able to pick one or two things that will help us in our day-to-day life. It says this master, he went into his garden and he planted and left, which is normal. And everybody, when you go to your garden, you plant, you don't sleep there to watch over the garden. You have to go home. But interestingly, somebody else had access to his garden. Interestingly, somebody intruded into that garden. There was an intruder. And what did the person went to do? Probably when he was planting, the person was somewhere watching him. Probably when he was busy planting, that person was plotting in his heart what he wanted to do after the master had finished all the hard work, after he had left. And lo and behold, after he had done all the hard work he had planted and he left, tired, exhausted, he went home and slept. And the Bible said that while men were sleeping, while men were sleeping. Do you know that while me and you were sleeping, there are people that are awake? Not for good, though. While me and you were sleeping, there are people that keep awake to do evil. Who goes to the farm at night? We know that if you want to cultivate, you want to go to the farm, you go in the daytime when people will see you. But look at this, this devil, this enemy. The master had planted and went home, and he's tired, he's exhausted, he's gone to bed. That time he went to bed was when this enemy went and do his own planting. What did he go there to plant at night? How did he see the road to go into the farm? He was not scared. He went into somebody's farm at night while people were sleeping. He was awake. Awake to do evil. Me and you, we are sleeping. 12 midnight, 1 midnight, people are walking all over the place, plotting evil against the children of God. That is when they hijack people's destinies. That is when they plant the seed that is not meant to be. That is when they change people's stars. Who is keeping awake for your sake? Have you thought of that? Who is not sleeping for your sake? Who is doing overwork for your sake? Anyway, the Bible said that this master planted and left, and at night the enemy went. And what did the enemy went there to do? To do his own planting. He went and planted a contrary seed to what the master planted. A seed that is liable to destroy the seed of the master. Because wheat and tare cannot grow side by side. It's an upside down arrangement, like my father Apostle Johnson Suleiman will say. It's an upside down arrangement. How can somebody plant wheat? Another person will go and plant tares. It's an upside down arrangement. It doesn't rhyme. It's just like you want to drink tea. You made your tea. Instead of adding sugar, you went and added salt. It's an upside down arrangement. Or you went and added ground pepper inside your tea. They don't complement. And that was exactly what this man did. That is to tell you his heart was full of evil and wickedness. But what happened? Even the master did not realize that something was wrong. Somebody went to your farm and planted another different seed. You did not even realize it. I will show you how I know he didn't realize it. I will read it off from here. And it says here, verse 27 says, so the servants of the household came and said unto him. He did not realize it was a servant that realized that something was wrong. How come that all of a sudden my master is behaving funny? How come all of a sudden my lady is behaving funny? Something is wrong somewhere. The servant came and said, so we've realized that after you left the field, something else has happened. And because the servants were vigilant, they noticed that the master planted good seed. And now they've noticed that there's another contrary seed that had been planted side by side with the master's seed. And they alerted their master. And what did the master say? The master said, that's the particular place I'm interested in. He says here, verse 28, he said unto them, an enemy had done this. What the master said is an indication that the master was in the spirit as well. The master must have been going through a lot of things in his life. That is not the first time he was facing attack. That was not the first time that the enemy was challenging his destiny and his future. Because if it was his first time, he wouldn't have realized that it's the handwork of the enemy. He would have thought, oh, it's just a weed. Let's weed it off. But because he knew that this can only be the handwork of his enemies, he told the servant, he said, an enemy had done this. The question I have today for us is this. That situation you are in, are you even aware that something is wrong? That condition you find yourself, are you even aware that it's not God's destiny for your life? That tear, the tears you're shedding every day, are you even aware that it's not the plan of God for you and your future? The realization of where you are is what will catapult you to your next level. If you don't even know you have a problem, the solution is far, far away. If you don't even know that you're being robbed, you're being robbed of your blessings, your destiny, your style, every good thing that God has purposed for your life, your deliverance is very, very far away. You must come to the realization that, no, I'm more than this. The way I'm seeing myself is not what I'm so. It's not the way I'm supposed to be. It's not the plan of God for my life. The moment you begin to think like, how come?